Mr. Bill Engvall. Mr. Jeff Foxworthy. Mr. Ron Tater Salad White.
Well, look at there, boys. We got stool men now. You know what? It's funny. We travel all over the country, and we all been doing this for a number of...
I never considered you a spinner.
This is the same guy yesterday afternoon. We're at the Lincoln Memorial, and he said, I had no idea he was that big. And Bill said, he's not even standing up.
You know, we travel all over the country doing these shows and stuff. And it's funny, being a comedian, people always come up to you and they go, hey, tell me a joke. Which is weird, because nobody walks up to a plumber and says, hey, fix my toilet. So I thought it would be fun. It's, what we do every night. Like, we finish a show, and you're jacked up from the show. You can't go to bed. So we sit around down at the bar or Waffle House or whatever, and we just tell jokes to each other. And I thought it might be fun to tell our favorite jokes tonight. All right. Yeah, just joke.
I gotta tell you, I'm dizzier than hell here. The doctor says to this feller, I got bad news and worse news. He says, oh, what's the bad news? He said, got 24 hours to live. He says, what's worse news? I forgot to call you yesterday.
All right, I got a 24-hour to live one. Guy gets up in the morning, 6 a.m., goes to the doctor. The doctor tells him he's got 24 hours to live.
I bet this is the same doctor.
Y'all want to sit next to each other?
So that night when the guy's going to bed, he tells his wife, he said, I've only got a few hours left. He said, I want to make love to you just as many times as I possibly can. And so they do it once, twice, three times, and then they fall asleep. Well, about 4:30 in the morning, the guy taps his wife on the shoulder. He goes, I want to make love to you one more time. And she goes, you know, that's easy for you to say, Jerry. You don't have to get up in the morning.
That's good.
Ronnie, you got a joke?
Nope.
All right.
His mind's like a lazy Susan. If you'll just bear with us, it'll come back around here in just a minute.
This guy's taking flying lessons. He's talking to his buddy. He says, first day in the air, the instructor informs me he's an 8th-degree black belt and a homosexual. And if I don't succumb to his sexual advances, I have to jump out of the plane. And his buddy goes, well, did you jump? And the guy goes, yeah, a little at first.
I like that.
This woman goes to the doctor, says she's got a digestive tract problem. And the doctor says, well, tell me about your daily routine. She says, well, I get up at 6:15 every morning and make my family breakfast. And at 8:15, I have a bowel movement. He goes, well, let's take an x-ray and see what the problem is. So he takes an x-ray and goes, well, there's a problem right there. You got 3 worms in you. We're going to have to operate. First worm goes, did you hear that? The second worm says, yes, I did. He goes, what are you going to do? He goes, well, I'm going to hide behind the heart. The other worm says, well, I'll hide behind the liver. And the third one says, I don't know about the rest of you fellas, but I'm catching you 8:15 out of here.
Let me try one more here. Right. One more here. All right.
Just the show was running a little long for some of us.
All right. I didn't know it was going to take this long, sir.
This fella goes hunting with his buddy, and he got the scope up, and he goes, oh, my Lord. I can see your house from here, and your wife's cheating on you with another feller. He says, I've had it with her. shoot her in the head and shoot him in the private parts. And he said, I'll get that in one shot.
I got to admit, the preacher told me that last week.
This guy's mother-in-law comes to live with him. And she's been living there for about a week, and he comes home one day, and she's laid on the floor, and he calls 911, and the ambulance comes and gets her, and they take her to the hospital, and he's out in the waiting room, and the doctor comes out after a while, and the doctor said, well, I got some good news and some bad news. And I said, all right, well, give me the bad news first. He goes, all right, your mother-in-law is not going to die. He said, she's had a massive stroke. He said, in fact, she's probably going to live 20 or 30 more years. He said, the problem is this thing has rendered her unable to speak. He said, she just makes this horrible screeching noise like a parrot now. He said, it's also disabled her from using her arms, and she can't feed herself. He said, for the next 20 or 30 years, you're going to have to feed her baby food 3 times a day. He said, also, it's made her incontinent. You're going to have to change your diapers and clean her up every single day of your life. And the guy said, oh, my God. He said, what's the good news? And the doctor goes, I'm just kidding with you. She died.
That's a good one.
But you laughed at it.
Mr. White?
There's a cruise ship, and there's a magician that works on the ship, and the captain had a parrot, and he liked to go to the show every night, but the parrot understood the show, and because he could talk, he would give away everything. You know, he's putting it in his sock, Brock. He put it up his sleeve, Brock. It's in his hat, Brock. And the magician just hated this bird, and one night he just snapped, and he pulled out a pistol, and he shot the bird, and the bird ducked, and the bullet hits a propane tank and blows the cruise ship to 1 billion pieces. The only survivors are the parrot and the magician, and they're floating out in the ocean on 2 little pieces of wood, and the parrot goes, all right, I give up, where's the damn ship?
All right, I got a ship joke. Back in the 1800s, this wooden warship was out cruising the ocean. And the guy in the crow's nest says, Captain, there's an enemy ship on the horizon. The captain turns to his assistant and says, bring me my red shirt. All right. He goes and gets his red shirt. The captain puts it on. The battle ensues. It goes all day long, and they don't lose one sailor. About 10 minutes later, assistant comes up to the captain and says, hey, I got to ask you something. He says, before the battle started, you said, bring me my red shirt. He goes, why a red shirt? And he goes, because if I happened to be shot and was bleeding, the crew would not notice the blood and they would continue to fight on. And he goes, wow, that's awesome. Next morning, the guy in the crow's nest goes, 20 enemy ships on the horizon. Captain goes, bring me my brown pants.